What is up, my butter biscuits? Y'all, what is up with the weather? I cannot take it right now. One day it's 68 degrees, the next day it's 91 degrees. I am dying. I literally have a headache from this weather change. It's throwing me for a loop. I feel groggy. I feel weird. And that sucks because I really wanted to do my full face of makeup today because I wanted to do a My Thoughts and Opinions video about Rem Beauty by Ariana Grande. A lot of you guys have been tagging me in that. And I don't know why, for some reason, it's kind of dumb of me, but I like to have my makeup done when I'm doing a My Thoughts and Opinions video about makeup. I think what it is because I don't know, I feel like it presents a little bit better, you know what I'm saying? Because like recently, y'all, I've been kind of, just in case you guys didn't notice, I've been kind of like inspired by the collections, like say for example the Kylie Jenner and the Freddy Krueger collection. I did my makeup inspired by the imagery. The same thing with the Jeffree Star Pricked collection, like I was inspired by that, you know what I'm saying? So I'm staying like on brand with it. I don't know, I feel like it looks cute, you know what I mean? But I'm just like not in the mood to do my makeup today because this weather is like, oh, it's literally 92 degrees in my garage right now. So I'm like, oh my gosh, all my underboobs are sweating. It is toasty up in here. Like, I'm just like, what's going on? It was literally just like 65 degrees yesterday, and then it's 90 degrees today. It's really irritating me. But anyways, y'all, I'm thinking about maybe I'll just do this regular old makeup, you know what I'm saying, that I do every single day for my Thoughts and Opinions video, but I don't really know. Anyways, within today's video, we're going to be talking about Manny MUA / Lunar Beauty. This is a follow-up video, so if you guys did not see the first one, I would recommend watching the first one. However, I will do a little bit of a recap within today's video, so that way you guys know what's going on, just in case you guys don't check out that previous video. Within today's video, we're going to be talking about Manny MUA because he did address the criticism about his palette, and this is just really something that I'm intrigued by because I told you guys specifically when it came to this Moon Prism blush palette, it really did throw me for a loop too, and I said that so many times in my previous video because the shades in here actually looked pretty light. Like these shades right here looked really light, and then when I put them on my skin, I was like, wow, they actually show up way different than they appear in the pan. And on top of that, especially in lighting online, because I did watch his reveal video from that Moon Prism palette, and I was like, you know what, the shades look really light in there, but they come out way more deep. So I was intrigued to actually do a review about the Outer Dimension face palette. I may do a review on it, I'm not too sure yet, but we'll see about that pretty soon, because I am curious as the depth. On top of that too, I was watching his Instagram story and I saw some pictures that he had posted just from his phone, you know, just on Instagram stories, and I'm like, the shades look way more deep on his Instagram story than they actually did underneath the studio lighting. And I feel like that's a big problem a lot of the times because we'll see so many collections out there and they're underneath so much studio lighting that they end up looking a little bit washed out. So that's why I'm like curious to get my hands on this and like do a review. I did mention in my previous video, I was like, this is type of this is a type of product that I kind of like would no longer really purchase because I don't freelance anymore. I don't do anybody else's makeup, so I don't really feel the need to have 10 shades of like contour and highlight, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm only doing makeup on myself. But I feel like it would be a pretty good review video. Anyways, he addressed this whole topic on his Instagram story, so we're going to be talking about that today. So if you guys are interested in that, of course, go ahead and keep on watching. If y'all are new here, make sure you guys hit the subscribe button, turn on your post notifications so that way you'll get notified when I upload a new video, and make sure I'll give this video a big thumbs up. I would appreciate that. Also, y'all, I got new videos coming on my second channel. I just uploaded a new one on Sunday. I'm going to be uploading another one on Saturday or Sunday, so make sure you guys subscribe to my second channel. I got some good videos coming, y'all. I'm actually like really excited for them, so make sure you guys subscribe over there. Anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get into today's video. All right, y'all, just to give you guys a little bit of a recap of what's going on with the Outer Dimension face palette by Lunar Beauty / Manny MUA, this is it right here. A lot of people were having, you know, constructive criticism about the palette and saying, you know what, the shades are just not deep enough, and he did mention that. He did say it within his video. He did also tweet about it as well too. I do want to go ahead and read some tweets right here because this is a little bit of the, you know, context, that way you guys don't have to go back to that second video if you guys don't want to. So somebody had commented him and said, I'm proud of you being Mexican and being open and coming out with your brand. People might complain about shade ranges, but they don't know they can mix colors to customize / create, and the hard work and coin you personally put in. Not sponsored. He responds to that and says, oh, thank you, baby, I'm trying my best, I really am. Compared to other contour palettes on the market, I think I did pretty good. And just like I said in my previous video, honestly, compared to what's on the market, I do feel like his actually does go into pretty good depth. However, it doesn't cover deep skin tones, you know. I said in my previous video, I feel like it would cover, based upon what I've seen online, I feel like it would cover medium to dark, but not dark to deep, and that's what the complaints are about. So he did say this again to somebody else. Somebody said, the packaging and concept are beautiful, but the shade range is not good. And he responded to that and said, I said it wouldn't fit everyone, but I did make sure it will cover a ton of different skin tones. The average contour palette has 6 shades and mine has 10. So yeah, pretty good compared to what what's on the market. And once again, that is true. Honestly, I did scroll through Sephora and I did look at other contour palettes. And you know what? A lot of them don't go into like full depth, an actual palette. Like a lot of people and myself too, we look at Fenty Beauty and we're like, oh my gosh, like her shade range is just so inclusive. But it's because she has single individual shades, not a full contour palette. And this is the thing that Manny MUA was opening up about on his channel. And I really like that he went into depth about this because a lot of people don't know. And I told you guys about my personal struggles with trying to come out with a brand and having a minimum order of quantity. The reason why he came out with the palette is because you would have to purchase so many SKUs if you did individual shades. So him coming out with a palette is a little bit more easy to reach that MOQ, which is the minimum order of quantity, rather than coming out with individual shades. Also, another thing that I wanted to say, just in case I didn't touch on the topic enough in my previous video, I literally love this concept. Like, just in case you guys did not know, because I have seen so many comments on his actual video as well as Instagram, people are really confused. They said, just looking at this palette, I'm confused. But me, obviously, as an artist, makeup artist, I literally looked at this and I was just like, I get it right away. You have those two shades in the middle, which are meant to customize your highlight or customize your bronzer slash contour. And they're meant to add a little bit more depth to the existing shades that are on the right or left hand side. I know a lot of people that look at that, they're like, what is this for in the middle? Some people were thinking that it's like a brow shade and like a highlight, you know, for under your brow. And I'm like, no, this is meant to just lighten up the lighter shades, or meant to deepen up the darker shades, you know? So the concept, I 100% love. I said that in my previous video. And I haven't really seen anything like this out there. So I do have to say, like, kudos to Manny MUA for like thinking of this concept, because it is really cool and it really is innovative. Yes, obviously the shades could have been way more, you know, in depth, but he does open up about that. I'm actually going to go ahead and play his Instagram story right here so you guys can hear what he has to say about it.
Guys, so I just want to jump on here really quickly and talk about my Outer Dimension face palette. And I just wanted to say that I'm seeing some concerns about whether or not people think that it would hit deeper complexions and that's not going to fit deeper complexions. And I want you guys to know that I'm seeing the comments. I'm absorbing the information. Like, your feelings are completely valid. They really are. Honestly, I was getting a little bit defensive. I was being kind of a bitch about it, to be quite honest. Because when you work really hard on something, when it's your own line, and you feel like you did a good job, it's so hard to hear people being like, it's not good enough, when it's like, but I worked 2 years on this, you know? And you start to like get into your own head about it. And you know, think back and you're like, but I was trying my best to be inclusive as possible with one palette, you know? And I understand if that's not enough. I do. And I'm hearing you, and I apologize for being defensive about it, because I have been. I've responded and I've been kind of a bitch. I'm not gonna lie, because it just sucks to hear when you actually thought you were doing the right thing and it turns out, you know, that you could have done more and that it wasn't enough for some people. So I understand. I am listening, I'm absorbing, and I want my brand to be the best it can be. Like, I would never, just know, like, genuinely, that I would never purposefully leave anyone out of my brand. Doesn't matter the complexion, from the lightest to the deepest. Like, I would never purposefully do that. I always try to be as inclusive as I possibly can. And that's what I want to continue with and move forward with. You know what I mean? So I'm working on it, you guys. I understand. I appreciate your guys' concern and letting me know. But yeah, I kind of want to just talk about that really quickly, because just know that I'm not ignoring it. Yesterday was a really hard day for me. I don't even want to talk about it right now. I just need to stay busy. To be quite honest, I just need to be busy. So I appreciate you guys' concern. Let me just say that.
So there you see it right there. Honestly, I do have to say, I feel like he's handling it pretty well. Obviously, he's not used to hearing criticism about his brand, because so far his brand has been really, really good. If y'all did not know, this blush palette right here, I do believe it sold out and everyone was raving about it. And I have to say, this is, I've said it like so many times, it's literally been in my current favorite makeup products as well too. This is like my favorite blush palette literally ever. It got me back into blush again, because for the longest time I would just wear Warm Soul from MAC. And y'all, with this blush palette, I have been wearing these like four shades right here. I freaking love them. I feel like the pigment is so beautiful, because you can wear it very, very sheer, but then you could build it up. I love it. So that's why I'm like, you know what? I feel like his palette would actually have a really good formulation to it. I do feel bad for him in the aspect of, you know, obviously he's facing this criticism, but I do think that it's good. Like when people give good constructive criticism, then obviously the brand can take that, learn from that, and grow from that. So I think that he's handling it pretty good. He did come off a little bit defensive at first, but I feel like that is a normal human reaction. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like his baby and he's like, you know what? I put so much work into this. And then for people to be like, what's going on with this? But I do think it is really good for him, so that way he can like keep this in the back of his mind moving forward with his brand. I hope to do a review of this. Like I said, I'm not 100% sure if I am going to be doing a review of this, but I will let you guys know if I do, because I really am intrigued to see it in person. And honestly, because of the formulation of this, I feel like the formulation of that will be really good, but we'll see about that. So anyways, y'all, that wraps up this video. Make sure you guys let me know your thoughts and opinions on everything, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Peace out, Girl Scout.